creating a constant sense of dread is a difficult thing to do in cinema. Dread is a somewhat more abstract feeling than fear or even suspense. It's that intangible, anxious feeling that a film can give you just by inhabiting its world. It makes you uncomfortable in your skin and keeps you on edge, even when nothing unnerving is happening. Moments of dread aren't uncommon, but creating a constant sense of dread that envelops an entire film is a thing few directors have accomplished successfully. David Lynch is a master of it. Darren Aronofsky accomplished it beautifully in his first feature, Pi, and his latest film, Mother. And for my money, Denis Villeneuve crafted and sustained an all-encompassing sense of dread for the duration of his film, Enemy. I'll be breaking down the elements that I think contribute to this constant sense of dread. First, I want to direct your attention to the framing. This film is beautifully shot, but it is also intentionally off. Enemy often doesn't follow typical framing that you would see in a conventional film. Instead, the film uses framing and camera movements that audiences aren't accustomed to seeing. This can give a subconscious feeling that something is wrong. It can make audiences uncomfortable because they aren't seeing what they're used to. Shots are often left with a lot of headroom above characters, empty space that diminishes their size and adds mystery to portions of the frame. This distinct framing is used in a similar way to Mr. Robot. By now, you've undoubtedly noticed a commonality in all of the images. Color. If there's one color that comes to mind when you think of Enemy, it's yellow. The entire film is washed in a sickly yellow. If you look into color theory, just a few of the negative connotations for yellow are jealousy, deceit, illness, and danger, all very appropriate for the subject matter of the film. The whole world of Enemy being coated in yellow not only creates a unified look for the film which enhances its dreamlike nature, but also takes away any sense of safety and replaces it with constant threat of danger. Other than yellow and the occasional yellow-washed green, the primary colors in this film are black, gray, and dirty brown. This lack of color is very strongly reinforced by the next component I want to talk about, the architecture. Enemy was shot primarily in Toronto, with the city being a key part of the film. The world that Enemy creates is one of sprawling cement and towering structures of concrete. The brutalist architecture and crushing nature of the constant gray stone feels both trapping and alienating. It stops our characters from melding with the world and yet keeps them trapped just on the surface, living in that dreadful space. The design of the city and the way it is presented compound any danger or intrigue that may be present. Next, I want to talk about the establishing shots, the skylines, the landscape shots. I just talked about how the architecture of the city itself adds to the sense of dread. Now I want to talk more specifically about the way the city is shot, particularly in these shots. These shots are macro. They pull away from the characters, almost offering a break from the nightmare, except this film doesn't waste a shot. Even these macro high shots are made unnerving, by the smog that chokes the city in its bleakness, or by the unexpected camera movement that accompanies them. These shots are the closest thing the film offers to a reprieve. These shots begin to feel like a safe space, until this happens. The film lulls you into a false sense of shallow security with these shots, so that this image hits you harder when your guard is down even ever so slightly. Now we get to the music and sound design. The score for Enemy is creepy and ambient, but also mixes in more traditional instrumentation in places, which serves to make the ambient elements of the score feel more distant and unnerving. And the traditional instrumentation that is there has an off quality to it. The music also incorporates sounds often used to conjure up images of spiders in the listener's mind, which of course correlates to one of the film's central symbols. The sound design of the film has a cacophonous effect. The atmosphere is dark and consuming, even overpowering when it wants to be. There is hardly ever a quiet moment. An outdoor conversation between two characters is pervaded by loud wind and shaking tree branches, not allowing silence to creep in between their words.
Hello.
Hi.
Is everything all right?
This cacophonous sound design is near constant, and the moments that aren't loud are often not just quiet, but silent. A complete absence of sound puts the viewer on edge, the absence made even stronger by how out of place it feels within the otherwise busy acoustic environment. All of these elements swirl together and create a constant sense of dread that never lets up. This sense of dread takes seemingly normal moments and moments where nothing happens and makes them incredibly tense. Enemy isn't fully a horror film, it's more of a thriller, and IMDb only lists it as a mystery thriller. But because of this tension and sense of dread that hangs over the film, Enemy is creepier and more genuinely frightening than most horror films. So check out Enemy if you haven't seen it before this macabre month of horror. It's a lot less well known than Denis Villeneuve's other films he's made since he became an American filmmaker. This video essay was sponsored by Audible. If you go to the URL audibletrial.com/brickwall, you can get yourself a free month of the service and a free audiobook download of your choosing. That's audibletrial.com/brickwall. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, check out the other stuff we do here. There's other video essays, there's movie reviews, there's all kinds of stuff here. You can click that P that's on the screen there to become one of our patrons. What that means is that for each full-length video we put out, you would be supporting us financially. You get perks for doing so. If you don't want to sign up for Patreon or be tied to a per-video basis, you can make a one-time donation via the PayPal link in our description. We really appreciate that. It's a big help. Thanks for watching. Bye.